Hello, hello. It's so good to see all of you. And I want to welcome the precious name of Jesus. I just muted myself again. It seems to be a pastime. But it is such an exciting evening, morning, afternoon, wherever you're watching from. We are just so excited. We've been praying in the spirit in the studio area before we went live. And we could feel just this electricity building as God was beginning to just move among us. And we know God is going to move among you tonight as well. I want to also welcome all our DGAN ministers that are watching. Thank you for your messages of encouragement. And we hope that we can be an encouragement to you. And for all of those watching in DGFC, DGAN, all our friends and family in Christ, we welcome you in the precious name of Jesus. And if you are standing in agreement with the word you are already going to receive and may have already received but not yet heard, I want to ask you to shout an amen right there. We also would like you to let us know where you're watching from tonight. And, welcome. Let's just do a few welcomes in because we know that we're also just busy building as people are coming on. And I know that it's great to see our own names, but we're not always keen to see everybody else's. That's the truth. But, hey, let's have a look and see. Oh, welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, welcome. There's Cape Town. Welcome, Cape Town. Welcome, Melanie. Ah, hello, Elmarie. Good to see you. Good to see you. Hey, Renette, good to see you. Ah, hello, Teacher David. Good to have you with us. Absolutely awesome. Hello, Liani, all the way from Potch. We've got people watching from all over the country and all over the continent. Hello, Ilonka. Good to see you. Hello, Yako. Awesome, awesome. Hello, Pat. Good to see you. Hey, Kim. Hello, 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 Johan, good to see you. Yes, hello, Grant, good to see you. Hello, Helen, good to see you. Awesome, awesome. And just so that you know as well, our guest tonight is able to see your comments right here from the studio as well. Hello, Pastor. Oh, hello, Pastor Reline. Hello, Pastor Louis, good to see you. Hello, Apostle Christopher. Good to see you. Hello, Mpo. Hello, Max. Good to see you. Well, without any further ado, just again, please like and share this. Let other people be blessed tonight. So if you haven't shared this broadcast, do it right now. Press that button right where you are because God is about to stir hearts tonight. When we release the prophetic, we know it's the anointing. It is not us. It's the Jesus Christ that is in us. Amen. It's the power of the Spirit. And so tonight, I want to welcome. It's so awesome to have. Let me just get my facts straight over here. There we go. Where's Prophet Bob? He was here a minute ago. Ah.
Proxy for him.
Oh, okay. All right. I was just about to go. And without further ado, I'm about to introduce Prophet Bob. And yay! As I'm going to introduce you, Prophet Bob.
Our guest is back.
I'm so sorry. They came in. I had to move my car. They came and knocked on my door, and I had to go move my car for them. So sorry.
Nothing. It's live TV.
Yes.
It's all good. It was good. You must have run a mile there. We welcome you in the precious name of Jesus. Prophet
yes.
Bob, part of DGAN, also based in the USA and Texas. And we know a lot's going on around the world right now, Prophet Bob. Welcome.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. I'm very happy to be here.
Oh, it's so good to have you. Wow. So good to have you with us. Gosh, wow. It's so incredible that we can be so many miles away. There we are. Everybody's greeting you on the screen over there, Prophet Bob. And so we are looking forward to what God is going to do. And we have also with us Prophet Mariki, who's going to be joining us. I'm surrounded by prophets tonight. Mm-hmm. It's so awesome. And Prophet Brenny, who's also going to lead us in some song just in a moment, just so we can move even deeper into the presence as the sound is released tonight. So I'm going to hand over, without any further ado, to you, Prophet Brenny, as we sing. What are we singing tonight?
We're going to sing Yeshua, Apostle.
Oh, great. Let me ask you right now, what are your expectations for tonight, Prophet Brenny?
Apostle, I'm expecting the Lord just to move in such great power. We felt the presence of the Lord yesterday. We felt the presence of God so powerfully, even just in the studio earlier. And I'm expecting just us as God's people to come with surrendered hearts, yielded hearts, with our garments of praise, with our garments of worship, laid before the Lord as a fleece. Right now in Jesus' name. And even right now, the atmosphere, Apostle, is prepared in every home. Every home's atmosphere is prepared to just receive the presence of God, receive the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, that there is a united sound going forth right now with everybody that is online, whether they're watching it live or delayed, Lord God, or on replay. I know, Lord God, that we are uniting right now to release a sound into the atmosphere that will cause a shifting and a shaking in our territories and our homes. So release that sound.
And the lyrics are right there on your screen under the comments. I think it's been pinned for you. Yeshua, my beloved. Let's sing it together as we come into the presence of the Most High God.
My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. My beloved is the most beautiful among thousands and thousands. Yeshua, Yeshua. Yeshua, Yeshua. For yours, for yours. is the kingdom yours? Is the power yours? Is the glory forever? Amen. For yours is the kingdom yours? Is the power yours? Is the glory forever? Amen. We declare it. For yours is the kingdom yours? Is the power yours? Is the glory forever? Amen. Yeshua.
Church, your body of Christ, your bride to arise. Where you're calling your body, Lord, in this time, and you're saying it's time to wake up, church. Don't go back to the way things were. Yes. Hallelujah. It's time to wake up. It's time to arise. Time to arise.
Come on, sing that out prophetically right now, Prophet Brandy. It's time to wake up. Come on, Church of Jesus. It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up. Open down your house. It's time to wake up. Everything that must go, must go. It's time to wake up. Oh, Church of the Lord, it's time to wake up.
So as we hear the word of the Lord speaking to us, the bride, remember the Lord bringing us a word on Sunday, just talking to us, speaking into our hearts to say that this season, it is the hour of the almond tree. It is the hour of the almond tree. Revival cannot take place without a proper foundation being laid. The Lord has been laying the foundation in the valley. The Lord has been laying the foundation as you have been pushed into even that cleft of the rock. It is a season right now. There is going to be the travailing before the prevailing. The church shall prevail. The glorious church shall prevail. But there is going to be a travailing before the prevailing. And then an unveiling. It's time to wake up. It's time to arise. Shanama Kalaba Kalaba, it's time. It's time. I'll sing that up, Ray.
It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up. Wake up, oh sleeper, wake up. It's time to wake up.
The Lord is calling us right now. The Lord is calling us into a time where we need to put down. There's certain things we've had in our hands. Thanks, Prophet Brandy. You can carry on playing. Just take off that drum. I never thought I'd say take off the drums, but I'm saying it now. It's time to arise. And in order to arise, there's some things we've got to put down. There's some things we've got to put down. Some of us have got the wrong implements in our hands. Some of us were moving in a flow, and somebody and something cut in on your race. And the Lord is speaking to us to say it is a season for the almond tree to blossom. In South Africa, we're coming into winter. Or we're supposed to be in winter. But there is a symbolic, prophetic release that God wants us to understand of the many firsts that are to come. We've moved out of a seven-year period of what was for many a time of drought. But the Lord gave us prophetic words which are always faithful and always true. And yes, we are moving into revival, but we can't shout out the words revival unless it first occurs in our hearts. So God is preparing the ground of our hearts, the soil of our hearts, so that we can move into that place of revival, because the church building doesn't come into revival. It's the people that come into revival. The building is permeated with the atmosphere of Jesus, with the atmosphere and the Spirit of Christ, and the voice and the Lord speaking out the prophetic word. And the power of God manifests through miracles, signs, and wonders. But it's time to wake up. Church, some of us think we are awake, but God wants us to get out of our beds. Sometimes we may be awake, but we're still in our beds. Get ready, get ready, get ready, for the voice of the Lord will be heard. I want to bring right now. Lord, we just thank you right now for prophetic voices that are being released in this hour. Oh, let your voice be heard. Put down your old systems. Put down your old systems. Because God is ushering in something new in the church. Don't look back to the things that were. The word of God is speaking out to us. The things that were are not going to be in the season of the almond tree. Prophet Bob, Prophet M, and Prophet Bran, let this flow just happen now. As it comes out, just share as you would like to share. We're here in conversation right now, in the prophetic, in conversation, in the spirit, back in the physical realm, whatever it is and whatever it takes. We're living in trying times. Amen. Prophet Bob, woo, you can surely share on that too. Woo.
Yes. Thank you, Apostle. I want to share what the Lord has shown me as we were getting ready for this. Excuse me. I saw this moment for everyone, very similar to the night of Passover when the last plague was coming upon the land, and everyone gathered in their homes, and the blood was put on their doorposts so the terror would pass over. But in this case, we're gathered in our homes, and the blood is on our hearts, and this is not a terror that's passing over, but it's the Spirit of the Lord passing over to revive us and to bring us into a new place. And I thought, well, that's a strange, sort of a strange analogy that God showed me. But he also said that just like that moment of the Passover, that was the last plague. The Lord said, some of these people that are here, many of these people that are here, this is going to be the last break off of what's been holding them back. So the new season can start and you'll move on, and you won't have the things of the past that have held you back beyond this point. You can move on. So it's a moment of the last of the things that have been holding you back to move on, to pass over and move on to the new.
Shakalabala
barashanda. Thank you, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Prophet Bob, I think it's quite prophetic that the boxes behind you are packed. I think it is such a symbolism of a message to each and every single person. You cannot move if your boxes aren't packed, right? And we want to move forward in this new era, in this new hour. So I think that prophetic symbolism even behind you is you are ready to move forward. You are ready to move to a new place. You are ready for the Lord to move you to a new place. You are ready for that dwelling place that the Lord has prepared you for, and that the Lord has prepared. You are ready to move there. Your stuff is packed. You are ready. And I think for us as the bride of Christ, that is so symbolic to say, are you ready, bride of Christ? Have you packed? Are you ready? Are you awake? Are you alert? Do you know where I'm taking you to? Do you know what provision there is that you needed to get ready for that move? And I think, Apostle, I just feel so deeply in my spirit, Prophet Bob, if you can just release a little bit more of the importance of, you know, being ready to move. Because I think the Lord is calling us to move. The Lord is calling us to. I brought a word yesterday evening just in our church board, just that there is a shifting taking place. The Lord is shifting. But are we ready? Are we positioned for that shift? So if you can maybe just, share your heart on that.
Sure, sure. Yeah, and to move forward to a new place, like I got rid of a lot of things that I'm not taking with me. It's a real time to purge out some old things, to think about what you have, what you want to take with you, and what you want to let go of that you don't want in your new season. And now's the time to do that. And many times you cannot move forward if you're holding on to these things of the past. And it could be unforgiveness. It could be relationships. It could be all kinds of things. But let go of those things that you need to let go of that are troubling you, and move on to the new season, what God has for you. We have a role to play. God opens doors. He does many, many things to help us, but we have a role to play. And sometimes it is the letting go that's the most necessary before you can move forward. Oh, hopefully that speaks to somebody. Yeah.
Whoa. Amen. Amen.
Whoa.
So much in that word. I heard earlier, Prophet Bob, just as you were speaking to, and just in when we were praying, the Lord said, don't assault the vault. So I think sometimes we've got to do our part, but we also have to be sensitive to how the Lord wants to move and shift us. We've got to do our part. We can't assault the vault and expect it to open. The Lord is going to give us that combination to move forward and for those doors to open up. We've got to play our part, but it doesn't help assaulting the vault to try and force it open. At the right time, the Lord will open those doors, but we've got to be ready to know the timing of the Lord and the direction of the Lord. Right, Prophet Bob?
That's correct. That's correct. And sometimes, talking about seasons in this 7 years, I know I've come to the end of a 7-year period, and I wasn't even thinking about that until Apostle Deborah mentioned. I thought, wow, this really is a 7-year period that we've all been together and gone through. And I know in my heart, I started sensing this about a month ago. And of course, here in America, we've got this whole situation with Donald Trump and this. I mean, it's unbelievable what's going on in my country. But we all have this great hope now that that is all going to change, and it's going to be a major change for our country. It's going to be a major change for people that are downtrodden and marginalized and treated like subhumans. You know, all of that is about to shift, and it's going to shift in a major way. I can feel that. And I feel that same sense about everyone here and about what God is doing. It's a time of real growth and new things and new doors opening and new opportunities. And I believe there's some people online that are considering taking a new opportunity, and it can always be so scary. You may have to move physical locations to a different city. You may have to leave family members for a time to go. But the way you know how to make the decision is in your heart, you will feel good about it. And your head may say, oh, these are all these reasons why I shouldn't or couldn't or whatever. But in your heart, you'll know, this just feels good to me. This whole thought of doing this feels good. And that's how we're led. It's not usually a thunderbolt out of heaven. It's that inward witness that says, I have something for you, and it's over here. If you'll have faith and make a step in the direction, things will open up for you. And hopefully that ministers to somebody on here.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, I think many of us can receive that. And Prophet Baba, also, you know, I just want to link up to that, that I think sometimes the Lord speaks, but we also don't hear. Our eyes and our ears are closed, and we're unable to see maybe the signs or interpret the signs or hear from our leaders or don't receive the confirmation sometimes because we want to head in a different direction. Right. We want to move to a different place or to a different venue, and that may not be God ordained. And I think that sometimes I felt earlier when I was also just preparing my heart that some of us may have stumbled backwards. Instead of moving forward with revelation, we've stumbled backwards. And if we stumble backwards, you know, it's hard to maintain your balance. But if we move forward, there's a momentum that builds. And I think in this hour, people who are listening online, Prophet Bob, just we've got to be attentive, right? That's what you said. We've got to be present. We've got to be awake. We've got to be alert because we won't hear the voice of the Lord. And I was reminded that during lockdown, you said yes of this difficult time. And Apostle also mentioned that right at the beginning. My wife and I don't go to the beach often, but because we haven't been able to go. I mean, I'm desperate to go take a walk, you know, along the promenade, which we are allowed to do now. But there was a hunger in my heart to go do that, which I haven't had the opportunity to do, or it was closed to me. So I think the Lord was also saying to some people tonight, what are you hungering after? You know, where is your heart? Where is your focus? What are you hungering after? Have you missed sort of the right things in your heart? Have you missed the presence of God, i.e., have you hungered after it? Because I think if we hunger after it, the opportunity or chance to stumble backwards are fewer than us being able to move in the presence and the power of God and know that we're heading in the right direction. So Prophet Bob, if you have to just release a word over how important it is to head in the right direction, a God-led direction.
It's always easiest to stay in a comfort. There's comfort, even if your situation is not what you want. Are y'all able to hear me okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Prophet M, okay.
Yep.
It's always easy to stay in a place of comfort, even if it's not where you want to be. You're not satisfied. When you feel that sense of I'm just not satisfied here, that's when it's time. God is doing something. He's stirring up that nest and saying, okay, it's time to grow a little bit. You know, you can't sit under this bush and let the sun be blocked. Now you've got to get up and go. Right. So when you're feeling that, and I'm dealing with a family member now, who's been in a situation for 38 years that has never gotten any better. And it's such a battle for them to say, I want to change, but I have to. Yes, you have to get out of your comfort zone of 38 years to ever grow. And sometimes it is the hardest thing in the world to try to do, but it's necessary or you'll never be where God is wanting you to be, where God is trying to help you, right?
Yeah.
So, God is always about trying to help us, but we have to let him help us. So don't be afraid to move toward what God is leading you to do. Don't get caught up in waiting for some spectacular sign to confirm. You'll know it in your heart. You will know it. And if you move forward and it doesn't work, then you'll know, well, this was not God. But most people that I've ever met can hear that inward witness in their spirit. They know when something, this is right. It's not just in your head. It's in your spirit. That's what you listen to. That's how God leads us. So do it. There's such opportunity. And I see it, especially in South Africa, for people. And I just see like, how you go to a concert and people take their lighters? Well, used to. I don't know, in my day. Or we used to strike a match, you know, back in the old days. But anyway. You know, I'm talking about the phones or whatever. And you see one light, then you see another, and the lights can get brighter and brighter. And that's just how I see the whole of South Africa. There's such an opportunity for people's lights to really shine and really to be bright. But you have to shed the framework that your mind has built up around you about this is impossible. I can't do this because of I'm in this situation or I'm there or whatever. You cannot allow yourself to think that way. You have to think beyond that and give God room to breathe and to move in your life and to take you to a place that's going to be much higher and much better than you could ever have figured out before. And he'll give you the skills. He will qualify you. He will do whatever you need to put you in the place where you need to be. And don't be afraid. I think that's the main word is don't be afraid to try. Don't be afraid to move. Don't be afraid to go for it.
Amen.
Whoa.
And Prophet Bob, if I can maybe just come in there, I think in this hour, as Apostle brought the word, in this hour, in this new era, it is important to move forward with revelation. And the Lord gave me a word earlier this week that we are in a transition month or transition period, but I felt it was a month. This month is key, from 6 to 7. It's key. How we move forward in transition is going to be critical. We are undergoing a change. I think as a country, as a nation, as churches, as the global body of Christ, as individuals, whatever it is, you spoke about that purging process. You spoke about, you know, letting go of the baggage to free you up to be able to move and to move swiftly. And the word that comes to mind is nimbly. We have to be nimble in this season. In other words, we can't carry the baggage with us. We have to, what did you call it? When you downsize, you know, you just let go of stuff. And I think the Lord is moving us and from one position to another. I wrote down here, shifting. We are shifting and not remaining static or stationary. Mm-hmm. Because I think sometimes that fear disables us and keeps us in a place where we almost become paralyzed. We don't move forward in the calling God has given us. We don't move forward in the journey that the Lord has put us on because we think, gosh, I can't sometimes maybe I won't. The Lord is calling the bride of Christ back to say, I want to move you forward with revelation and in revelation. But to be able to do that, to transition, you have to transition correctly. And the other thing, Prophet Bob, I wanted to talk about is, you know, we're not islands. We don't operate on our own. We're part of a collective. We're part of fellowship. We're part of family. And the one thing I think the Lord impressed upon me is, the Lord's asking us, who are you going into battle with? Who have you got at your side? Who do you have that is strengthening you? Who do you have like an Aaron and a Hur lifting up Moses' hands, Moses' arms? Who do you have that is strengthening you, that is praying over you, that is walking alongside you, that will go to war with you and for you? I think it is so important, Prophet Bob, for us to be, you know, in this transition month, aligned correctly to release the fullness of that new hour that the Lord is revealing to us. It's like something is being unraveled. But if we don't have the right people around us to go into battle with, we're gonna struggle to receive the unveiling. If you can maybe just speak to us on that.
Yes, I got to share what has just hit me in the spirit. Though some people are in the wrong relationships, and sometimes when you're in the wrong relationship, there will be a certain level of comfort, but you know in your heart, and once again, it's always going to be what's in your heart about this. You know in your heart, this is not right for me. And if it's not right for you, it's not right for them either. And if you're dealing with that and going through that, and you have a fear of letting go and a fear of moving on, the things that God has for you, that place of peace, that place of victory and growth, you can't get there with that. In that situation, you can only get what you can get, and it's always going to be tempered by that situation that you're in. And so, you know, just examine yourself. I mean, I'm not saying anything to anyone that you don't already know. I'm just letting you know the Spirit of the Lord has motivated me to bring that out and cause you to think about it again. If you're in the wrong relationship, you definitely need to deal with that, because God is trying to do something wonderful in your life for you and for the other person. It's not always just about us. It's about everyone. And so do the hard things. Sometimes it's the hard things. But anyway, sorry, I wasn't expecting to say anything like that, but I felt like it was very necessary. What keeps coming to me, for so many people, it's the way you're thinking about your life and your future. And you have to let your mind open up for God to show you more. You know, I was told many things when I first came to the Lord about how God was. But God would come to me and show me by his spirit in ways that he really wasn't quite like that, what I was being told. And there's so many things in our lives that we're told that they have to be this way and that way. But God, I'm telling you, God will do things you can't expect and you can't necessarily plan for. You just got to position yourself so God can move. And what I mean by that is be willing to let go, be willing to clean out and say, God, whatever you're wanting me to do, I'm going to go do it. And don't look back, and he will open the door. So I know that sounds very bold and adventurous, but I just believe there's some people. I know there's ministry callings on people that are online now that are held back. They're not pursuing that because they're focused on making a living. They're focused on this and that or whatever. But if you will let God open that ministry avenue in your life one step at a time, then everything else will begin to come together for you. And being plugged in with this group and with Apostle Deborah and Prophet M and the church, you have guidance, you have leadership to help you grow and develop that. They've helped me tremendously over the years. And so I encourage you, whatever you're feeling called in ministry, don't say, oh, there's already somebody else doing that, or, oh, I could never be as good as that person. I can promise you it's usually the people that feel the most unworthy that God uses to the fullest, because once you realize God will use you, it's a euphoric thing because you do feel so unworthy. So let yourself enter in more. Let yourself learn how to receive more and reach out for prayer. Reach out to Apostle Deborah. Reach out to them. Let them, you know, help you open up and enter in. I feel strongly there's people that are really held back that need to really let go, really let God. And if you don't mind, I'd like to pray over that, if you don't mind. Lord, I just thank you for the people that are with us, Lord. And I just, Lord, I just ask you, Father, help them to let go. Help them to have the courage and the clarity, Lord. And I just come against foggy thinking and confusion in the hearts of people, and people saying, I want to, but Lord, I just thank you. Help them get rid of that. Help them get rid of the but. Help them get rid of the no, I can't. Lord, help them, Lord, just rise up and shine, Lord. I just thank you that they are empowered. They are able. And Father, I just thank you. I just come against roadblocks in their life that would try to hold them back, against family members telling them they can't. Lord, and I just give you praise right now, Father God, for their growth, the new that's going to happen. And I just pray that in Jesus' name. Thank you,
Lord. Oh, amen.
Amen. That was so powerful, Prophet Bob. And, you know, it's amazing. You know, so often the Lord shows us where we're aligned, where we need to be. But if what often happens is when we are slightly out of alignment, we can't always see that. We the lines get blurred and we you know, we're not quite sure of where, what, and how. But I always say to people, go back to where the Lord drew you in. You know, what? Just where were you drawn? Where was the spirit? Where was the anointing? Where were you getting, you know, where were you finding that alliance in the spirit, that covenant relationship or relationships where you would be covered? Gosh, I don't know what's happening to my mic. And God will reveal the truth. God will show us. God will show us and show up. And what you said, Prophet Bob, about relationships, can everybody hear? Am I on? What you said about relationships was very, very important. Mm. And what Prophet M said at the same time, because the period of June and July is a very strategic time. The enemy has often used this period of time. We have to understand it. We're still understanding the strategies in the spirit realm. But God wants to do something amazing in the period of June and July. The Lord gave us a word that we are living in an hour. This is a new hour. It's a new era. It's a new hour of a new era. And the reason for that is that an hour in the prophetic is much shorter than any other period of time. And in the window period, and I'm not saying thereafter, but certainly in June and July, God wants to reveal some things, deep revelation in the spirit, of things that are going to help us, propel us forward into not just forward thinking, but into spiritually minded decisions that are birthed in the wisdom of God. And we've got to be very careful. And you said, Prophet Bob, about relationships, just because you were just being obedient to the voice of the Lord. And I believe that, you know, so often we can be sidetracked by the wrong relationships. And anything I want to say that pulls us away from the Lord, that pulls us away from the direction of the Lord, if we're honest with ourselves, we've got to reassess, is this of the Lord? Usually when God brings someone into your life that is right, it will draw you into where you are aligned, the house that you are aligned, the people you are aligned to, and all of those things. So I want you to hear the words that have come from our prophets tonight, because these are very, very important words. These are words that are coming from the Spirit, and the Lord is busy imparting to us a wisdom from above, so that when we move forward, we won't miss the blossoming of the almond tree in our lives.
Apostle, can I just come in here? And I know that Prophet Bob, there's something stirring in your spirit right now, but I heard earlier, and it's interesting that you spoke about the relationships, because the Lord said to me, obviously who we have at our side matters, and you spoke about the relationship, not only who I go into battle with, but who's at my side. That matters. Matters for our destiny, all of those things that we know. But then the Lord said to me, it's like a 3D 3D, 3D. Is it a distraction? Is it a distraction? Or is it a divine alignment? And I think that's so key to evaluate, you know, who's at my side? Who am I going into battle with? Is it a distraction? Is it a distraction? Or is it a destructive thing? Or is it a divine alignment? And I think that's the message that you were trying to get across, you know, that inherently we may know which 3D, which one of the 3Ds it is. And I think the Lord wants to give us, and sorry to be a little bit poetic here, but like 3D vision, just to see and see a little deeper into the relationships and the affiliations and the alignments we have, to say, is it destructive? Is it a distraction, or is it a divine alignment? And as the Lord starts to reveal that we are able to turn off almost, or to turn those that are maybe not divine alignments, to just create some almost distance, and to say that's maybe not the time or season. So we need to evaluate, you know, if it's a distraction, you said cut it off. You said if it is destructive or it takes you away, cut it off. If it's a divine alignment, you said pursue it. You will know. Not out of a fleshly desire, but because the Spirit confirmed it, right?
Yeah, very true, very true. And I'll say also what Apostle Deborah was talking about, these couple of months, we're in a place of positioning ourselves for the next year. In my sense, I can sense the next few months a certain way. And next year, 2021, I feel like it's going to be a totally different scenario for many, many people, for countries and for economies and all kinds of things. And I believe God is trying to, part of what we're doing today is he's trying to help us get in position so we can access the new that's coming to the fullest, and we won't miss out. If we're stuck and unwilling to change or be open to change, we can miss what God is going to be doing in this next season coming up. And I think it's going to be as opposite of what we have now, which is going to be a wonderful thing, right? So Amen. Yeah, I just encourage everybody, just search your heart, let God speak to you. If he's giving you ideas, if he's saying, you know, whatever, pay attention to that. And if you want prayer with it, you know, contact someone. People can pray with you to help you, sort it out. But to just be open for God to speak to you about what he wants to do new in your life. It's not going to be the same old, what he wants to do new. Okay.
Yeah, and I think that's such a good word, you know, that new, that just that word, I think, stirs my spirit because it's not the same. And that's an exciting thing to look forward to, because not only does a new year provide new promises and new hope, and we know and look forward to 2021, because 2020 may have been a bit of a challenging year, but I think the Lord pushed us through this narrow place, as maybe a couple of years ago, to also show us some things and maybe to get rid of that baggage that you spoke about, Prophet Bob, earlier. And I think it also has taught us something, that, you know, not to take things for granted, to have an attitude, to use that phrase, an attitude of gratitude, but I think to also get smart in the spirit. What I wanted to say to people is we've got to get smart in the spirit, right? And that means just discerning. And that means being in the presence and being able to discern the will of God and to discern the direction of God. But to put it in plain language, get smart. Get smart about how the enemy operates. And I felt, Prophet Bob, that if I can maybe just shift the conversation to what I saw, was that the enemy comes under a cloak of darkness. And, you know, he operates undercover. But what I saw the people of God was doing in this hour, they were coming together. So they were locking arms with one another. They were joining forces, and they were outmaneuvering the enemy. And outmaneuvering is such a key word, I believe, for us in this season, because we are going to maneuver with the revelation of God. And I earlier this week, I had to look up what does maneuver in the secular definition mean. And it says a series of moves requiring skill and care. And people of God listening, it says a large-scale military exercise of troops, warships, and other forces. So what I believe the Lord is saying to us in this season, this transition period, this transition month, there's maneuvering happening. But we have to outmaneuver the enemy. And the only way we can do that is to get smart, to get discerning, to get around people, and to gather with other people so that we can move forward and outmaneuver the enemy that comes, you know, just to infiltrate, to distract, we know all of those things. So just if you can maybe take that image a little further, and just if your heart stirs or your spirit is stirred about that.
Yeah, what comes to me is that the enemy, one of his tactics has been to scatter people and to cause people to leave and to flee. And now is a season where God is drawing people back, and he's wanting people to come back into that place where you had peace, or that place where you were at being ministered to, that place where you had comfort. You know, it's the old saying, if you're a log on a fire, you can burn great, but if you fall off, you just kind of go out, right? And that's what happens. If you just kind of say, oh, I'm just tired of going to church, I'm tired of doing this, and then you just kind of die out, and you can't hear as clearly, you're just not in the zone. And it's, you know, God is, he's calling people back that have kind of been kind of on the fence, you know, about coming to church, on the fence about following God, on the fence about doing these things, and yet you're on the fence, and yet you can't seem to get your life straightened out, and not realizing that, man, church and my relationship with God plays such a big role in my life. I really need that. So I just believe that people are going to be coming back. You're going to be getting phone calls from people that say, hey, I need to come back in, and all of that kind of stuff. It's just God is wanting people to get ready for this next year, this next season that's coming. It's going to be a good one. And he's calling people to come back and to get involved and to get plugged in. And also, right now is a season to give. If God has put anything on your heart about giving, and it doesn't matter what your situation is financially, if God has put it on your heart to give, you need to give. If he hasn't put it on your heart to give, that's a different story. But God will speak to you about giving, and if you will be obedient to that, whatever it is, it releases something. I could talk to you for hours about how this works. I have learned it the hard way, but I can tell you, when I became obedient, when God showed me, not just when a minister said, if you give $100, God's going to give you $500. That's not what I'm talking about, okay? I'm talking about when God speaks to your heart and leads you to give. And it could be to a ministry, or it could be to your neighbor who is struggling, but it will be a giving thing, and God wants you to give. And when you do that, it releases something. I don't know how that works really, but I do know that it works. And as they say, you can never outgive God. I mean, things come back to you in many, many ways, but that's part of the letting go process. Let go. If God's telling you to give, give whatever it is, give of your time, give of your money, give whatever, but listen in your heart. If you have a leading to give, do it.
Sure. Wow. There's just so much that's being covered now. And, you know, I'm hearing kind of in my spirit, I don't know what's going on with my mic tonight. I'm hearing in my spirit that there is some kind of, you know, there's this a voice saying, you know, why aren't we talking about the hot topic? Why aren't we talking about, you know, injustice and racism and all of these things? And we absolutely don't just want to talk about it. We want to be those that are living our lives that way. But why I brought that up is because we are living in times, and this is moving in the, this is all about moving forward in the anointing, moving forward in revelation, hearing the voice of God as we've been in conversation together. And part of the reason that people leave churches and you know, that we're just human beings at the end of the day. But the one of the biggest things we know is the spirit of offense. And, you know, there's something very important we have to take hold of. Just as Prophet Bob was speaking, this word came into my heart, and I was busy looking for the scripture. But I want to tell you something. Offense drives justice back. I want us to hear this word. Offense drives justice back in whichever form that justice must take place. And I was thinking, now, where did this word come from? And then the Lord led me to Isaiah 59, where the people were busy confessing, and it's where the Lord says, surely the arm of the Lord is not too short to save, and surely God's ear is not too dull to hear. So God hears our cries. God hears our pleas in these times of injustice, in these times where everything seems to be going crazy in the world, where we seem to be battling for good leadership and in different spheres and different areas of our lives, of our governments, of our, you know, that justice seems to be just disappearing off the face of the earth. But offense drives justice away. Offense drives justice. So I feel like the Lord is just speaking to us to say, just to remove every single area of offense in our lives that would cause us not to see or hear what God is saying in this hour, so that we can move forward. Because offense doesn't just drive back justice, it blinds us to hear and see even these words, because we're so ready to jump on the kind of defensive that we are in that space where we aren't hearing what God is actually saying. And so God is not here to point a finger at us. God is here to put God's arms around us and to say, come, let me show you what I have in store for you. Come, look up and see the almond tree. Come, throw those things down. Put your shovel down. Put your spade down. Put your fork down. Grab hold of the implements of the spirit that I'm giving you so that you can be stirred. I'm bringing you in right now as well, Prophet Brenny, as you play in the background, as we bring this into a place right now where God's just shifted the atmosphere. God has spoken many things to us, but we don't want to drive justice back. We don't want righteousness and justice to be standing at a distance because of us as the church. It is the moment for the church to arise. It is the moment for the glorious church to take her place. Oh, how God's heart cries out.
Yeah, amen. Prophet Bob, if you can just enter into agreement with us. So I just wanted to declare Jeremiah 33, just over the people watching and over our lives and over the global body of Christ, and, you know, over every hungry person, over every person that is moving forward in revelation and seeks greater revelation or even just clarity, over people whose boxes are packed and said, I'm ready to move forward. I don't want to stumble backwards. So I want to read Jeremiah 33:3 over us. I want to declare it, and I want to enter into agreement with the prophets, the apostles, the people of God. Just everybody, can you raise your hands and say, Lord, I want to receive a Jeremiah 33:3 anointing.
Thank you, Lord.
For the Lord would say to us, call to me and I will answer you. So Lord, you're saying to us, call to me. We've had conversation with one another. We want conversation with you. We're calling on you and you're saying, Lord, you will answer. So Lord, I release that. I decree that and declare it over people. And Lord, then you say to us, I will tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. To move forward with revelation, we need to call upon the Lord. And the Lord will answer us. So Lord, we want to move forward in a Jeremiah 33:3 season in this month, in the spirit. We want to move forward in this hour with a Jeremiah 33:3 expectation and a determination. Prophet Bob, can you just declare that over people as a prayer, as a prophetic declaration? Call on me, says the Lord.
Father, we just thank you, Lord. We declare today, Father, that you said if we would call upon you, that you would hear us, Lord, that you would heal our land, Father God, that you would heal our hearts, Father. Lord, I just thank you right now, Father God. I pray over everyone listening, Father, everyone watching, Father God. Father, this is a moment, Lord God. This is a moment of shifting in their lives, Lord God, a moment that you're calling to them, Father God, that you're speaking deep into their spirit, deep into their heart, Lord God. Father, that things would open up, Father God, that things would release and let go that need to be gone, and offenses will be washed away by the Spirit of the Lord right now. Father, I just thank you that offenses are being washed away even this moment, Lord God. And Father, I thank you for the refreshing that comes, Lord, in those moments. Father, I just pray that everyone be refreshed, be energized, be encouraged, yes, Lord God. Father God, to lift up, Father God, to take on the new. Father, yes, God, I just give you praise right now. Father, I pray for healing, Lord, physical healing. Lord, and those that need it, Father God, I see back pain. I see, Lord, I see like arthritic pain. Lord God, I just command that to go. Father God, I see some heart problems, a little bit of heart palpitation problems. Lord, I just command that to go. Father, I just thank you right now, Lord, that you're a healing God. Father, I just thank you right now that this is a moment of healing, spiritually, physically, mentally, Lord God. I just thank you right now, Father. Lord, in Jesus' name, I give you praise, Father. We call it done. We call it, Lord God, we call it into what we need, Lord. We just give you praise, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank
Hallelujah.
You.
I pray over someone, the third and fourth vertebrae in your neck. I saw that you had problems. I don't know if it was an accident. I just saw that there are major issues with the third and fourth vertebrae. And the doctors have said, you've seen two or three doctors and you're about to see a specialist. And I heard the voice of the Lord say, be healed, be healed, be healed in the name of Jesus. We declare healing upon you in the name of Jesus right now. As Prophet Bob started declaring healing, we enter into agreement with you for healing, the Lord's healing balm to flow over you. I'm touching my neck right now in the name of Jesus. And we enter into agreement with you for supernatural divine healing. I see even a release right now. If it is you, I pray that you touch your neck area where that vertebrae is almost out of place. And you will feel the touch of the Lord Most High come upon you. And you will feel that release. And we pray supernatural healing in Jesus' name.
Whoa.
Ooh. 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 Prophet Branny, did you see someone's illness or ailment?
No, Prophet, I just had in my spirit the Lord showing me a crown that has been dusty, and it's almost like someone is thinking that the authority has been sitting on the shelf for so long that it cannot be used. The Lord's saying, take that crown and begin to dust it off, for in that crown is the authority. It is the authority of God that is in that crown. So it's dust off that crown tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Sharabakarabasu.
Yes. So what I saw with that was that some people's broken hearts, so because you've got a broken heart, you put the crown, you put something on hold. You put something on hold. Something that the Lord wanted you to pursue, a calling, a destiny, a walk, whatever it is. You put something of the Lord's on hold because of a broken heart. And we get that a broken heart, you know, can be devastating. But don't put the crown on the shelf to gather dust. The Lord would say to you this day, your heart will be healed as you pick up that crown, as you pick up that thing which you've put down on the shelf, as you blow on it. The Lord's saying, your broken heart will be restored in the name of Jesus.
Jesus, yes. Now, just saw, as we went there, I saw there was groups of people right now that, again, just in that Isaiah 59, as the Lord led me to it, where we spoke about justice being driven back. Ooh. There are some people that are feeling in their lives right now that the truth is nowhere to be found.
Wow.
That justice is driven back and righteousness is standing at a distance. That truth has stumbled in the streets. That truth is nowhere to be found. And even those that would shun evil become prey. And the Lord looked at all of this in Isaiah 59 and said, the Lord said, I'm displeased that there is no justice and could see no one. There was no one that would intervene. Oh, Lebabashakababa. Oh, prophets, I'm telling you, this is a season where there will be weeping before there will be prevailing. There will be weeping before there will be prevailing. For the blood in the streets, for innocent lives, for injustices. But the Lord says, my mercy, my love and my power are greater than all of these things, than all of these evils that have befallen the world. Amen. And I've come with my dunamis to restore, to revive, and to release you from the bondage and the captivity of those that would surround you with injustice, that would surround you with untruth, where you can't see the truth from a lie. But the Lord says, look up and see, for the almond tree is about to blossom.
Hallelujah.
It's about to blossom.
It's about to blossom. Whew.
Truth may have stumbled in the streets, but Jesus says to you, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Look to me, look to me. Don't lose your way in the streets of blood. Look up, look up, for my blood has touched your life. Don't look into the streets of blood, but look at me, for I am love. Look above, look above. God has not forsaken you. God has not forsaken you. Look up, look up. There's an anointing right now in these words that have been released. Look up, look up. Don't go back to things the way they were. Look up, look up, look up. There might be war in the physical realm, but the Lord said that I am warring for your soul in the spirit. There is a war in the spirit that is even greater than that which you see on the earth. The calamity that is befalling you shall be only a temporary thing. It seems like it's been yours, but the Lord said there is more. For I am about to increase my grace upon the earth, increase my mercy and my love. It's about to be birthed in new ways. Look up, look up, look up. See the almond tree. Hey,
the almond tree is blooming, is blooming. Oh, the almond tree is blooming. Just look up and see. Open your eyes, open your eyes, open. My bride, open your eyes, my
my bride and see. See what I have for you. See what I have.
You know what comes after Isaiah 59? I only clicked now. But the Lord just showed me to say this. 2 years ago, the Lord spoke this word over our church, and I know it's a word for now. The scripture brings such revelation. For after Isaiah 59, where the turmoil came and the evil had beset the world, and the earth was just full of untruth and the bloodshed of people and the evil from the evil one, the Lord spoke just before Isaiah 60 and Isaiah 59 verse 21. This was the covenant of the Lord over the church. Hear me. We always got Isaiah 61, 60 verse 1. But listen to this. Here is all of these things, the blood spilled streets of untruth, where truth has been laid on the ground. And it says in verse 21, as for me, this is my covenant with them, says the Lord, meaning the church, meaning the bride of Christ.
Hallelujah.
My spirit who is on you will not depart from you, and my words that I have put in your mouth will always be on your lips. On the lips of your children and on the lips of their descendants. Come on, hallelujah. From this time and forever, says the Lord. This is the covenant of the Lord over the church. Hear me. Shukalaba. And then we go to Isaiah 60 verse 1. Arise and shine, for your light has come. And the glory of the Lord rises upon you. Darkness may cover the earth, and thick darkness over the people. But the Lord rises upon you. There's a breaking out of the light of the glory of God. And God's glory is appearing over you. No matter what darkness may befall you, the glory of the Lord will expose the darkness. And the glory of the Lord is upon you, and nothing can take it from you. Lift up your eyes, it says in verse 4, and look about you. All assemble and come to you. Sons and daughters from afar are carried on the hip. We are birthing a new generation, the Lord said, in this time. Then you will look and be radiant, and your heart will throb and swell with joy. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh,
thank
I
you,
receive
Jesus.
That word. I thank you for that word. I receive it to myself in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name, the church will prevail. That means God's word will prevail in your life. That means that no matter what may be falling you, no matter what place you're in, that God's word will not go void in your life. Amen. I don't know, Prophet Bob, if you've got anything to add before we bring this into a closing moment, or if you've got anything to add as well, Prophet Brainy, just speak out.
Yeah, I don't have anything to add other than it's been a wonderful moment, and I've thoroughly enjoyed being here. Thank you for inviting me.
Awesome.
Wow, it's been such a privilege and a blessing to... We were joking with Prophet Bob earlier. We were saying, listen, Prophet Bob, I just want to tell you, you're about to have another baby.
We're just getting started.
Prophet Bob's about to give birth again. I tell you what, and when Prophet Bob's about to give birth, you got to know that there's some revelation being birthed over there.
Oh, yes.
Get ready, church.
It's noisy. It gets noisy and messy, doesn't it?
We love it. Wouldn't have it any other way. Oh, yes, Lord.
Wake up, church. Don't go back to the way things were. Come on. Pull down your old systems.
It's time to wake up.
It's like, yes, it's like God stripping us bare, you know, just so that we can be full of God, full of more of Jesus. Just, oh, fill us, God. Oh, yes, fill us, God. Oh, just
thank you, Jesus.
Begin to receive. There's an anointing, a release coming through. right now, if you're anywhere near, just touch your screens. Just let a moment of faith arise in you right now. Let the glory of the Lord come forth. We release that anointing. We release and seal the prophetic word that is being given out tonight in Jesus' name. Let's just all pray for Oh, yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
So in Jesus' name right now, we just want to decree over you. The Lord's light shall shine upon you, is shining upon you. The glory of the Lord will be manifest in your life. You are bought with a price and you are God's own. We declare and decree that in this hour we will be hearers and seers of what God is doing. Watch out for the months that God has spoken to us through the prophets of June and July. Watch out for the new birthing that God is doing in this hour. Not in this just this year, but in this hour. There's a distinct window period of something that God is busy with. Be ready in this hour. There are many broadcasts. There are so many people doing live streamings. It's incredible. But let your heart be stirred and pulled into the right place, into the right lane. Stay in the right lane in this season because God is about to unleash a glory. You know, we've prophesied so many of these things years ago, but we understand that we have patience because we wait for the timing of the Lord. And there's an excitement in my spirit the same way there was. I was telling our team yesterday when we came into prayer yesterday afternoon as we were praying for our nation and the nations and our church and our people. And the one thing that was really, really important is that the Lord showed us that there's been 7 years. 7 years ago in 2013, God started, 2012 it started, a birthing of revival in our church. There was just supernatural happenings in every single sphere we could think. And then it felt like there was a drought. And even though there's been amazing moves of God, many of us, and I know even many ministers, have experienced deep moments of drought, moments that have pulled them into deep drought. But I tell you right now that the time of drought is over. There are streams about to be seen in the deserts because the supernatural of God is going to break forth in power like we haven't seen. You know, we used to say, every year we say, oh, you're going to see and watch and wait. Well, I tell you what, we need to be ready because God is doing it in this hour.
Amen.
God is doing it in this hour.
Yeah, amen.
Shukaba. So this is so good. Thank you so much. Prophet Bob has been so good. It's so wonderful. We can speak to you like this all the way from across the water and across the sea, but we're right here in the same room. And we want all of you to be blessed. And I want to encourage you to all go back and watch this broadcast again and begin to write down some words as the Spirit ministers and speaks to your heart. Prophet Brand, did you want to release anything over us as we close in prayer tonight?
Amen.
Apostle, the Lord keeps putting this into my spirit that God is waiting for a response. We know that the word speaks about the earth groaning, okay? But the Lord is saying, I'm waiting for a response from my people. I'm waiting for a response, and a response means to action. It means to respond. It's an active word. And so I see God is saying, I'm waiting for a response from my bride. I'm waiting for a response.
Sure. That's good.
Like that.
That's good. Yeah. I mean, me too. Yeah,
that's good because it means that we have to have heard the word and then believe it and receive it in our hearts to activate it by doing, by responding.
Sorry, Apostle, I don't want to open this up again, but I think it's what Prophet Bob also said earlier. It's you've got to play your part. And I think part of that call that Prophet Branny just put to the church, the global body of Christ, is what Prophet Bob put to each individual. You've got to play your part. And then as the collective, sure, you've got to respond. So amen to that. Thank you. Thank you, amen. Prophet Bob. Always always wonderful to be in the spirit with you.
And we
thank you for having me.
Oh, Prophet Bob, thank you for being with us. And I know there will be many more to come. And we are praying for the USA just as we're praying for our country.
Hallelujah.
Just to end on this note, I know so many people are going, yeah, but what about what's happening in South Africa? And we're also having racism issues, and we're still having racism issues. It hasn't gone away. We're still dealing with the reality on both sides. And it's all good, you know. We've got to understand that we've got to stand firm and strong and lead the way as the church. We've got to be those that are lovers of each other to show the way and lead the way if others won't. And just help people understand that, that, you know, we have to come to a place where we realize that there are people groups that are marginalized that have not been treated equally, and that we have to then highlight that in order for people to see and become aware of this reality. And so we pray right now for, we're praying for the states, we're watching, we're praying for South Africa, we're praying for the nations regarding racism. I don't know what's going on with my mic. Racism particularly, but I know God is busy doing something in the nations with all of us. There's a tide that is turning. We can feel something is stirring. There's something shifting, and it's going to shift quickly. Amen. So let's all be aware and ready for what God is about to do. And Prophet Bob, thank you so much again. Thank you to Prophet M. Thank you, Prophet Branny, for just playing us out with such a beautiful a song, and I just rebuke any gremlins in my microphone tonight.
Glory to God. Bless
and I just want to speak a blessing you, over Jesus. Everyone. Just say goodbye to everybody, and we're going to close off. And thank you, Prophet Bob. It's not the last. We're going to hear from you, and we love
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Love y'all too.
Send our love to everybody over there.
Thank you, Jesus.
We'll see you all soon. Don't go away, Prophet Bob. We're going to say goodbye to you in the control room in a moment.
Okay.
Amen.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, everyone.